came from here. He came to the United States, we think around 1855. And he worked on the railroad and started a family. And I'm descended from his oldest daughter, Maggie. But it's just wonderful to be here and to be able to sing the song here in this space. And if I forget any of the words, please jump right in and let me know. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara, so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is so empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely infected, a third to a half of them bad. And your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad and be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your fortune. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble. I suppose he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of, and now there's nothing to burn. And Bridget is happy, you named a child for her, you know she has six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind, oh, when will you be? Kilkelly, Ireland, 1880, dear Michael and John, my sons. I'm sorry to give you the very sad news, your dear old mother passed on. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly, your brothers and Bridget were there. You don't have to worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. And it's so good to hear that Michael's returning with money he's sure to buy land. For the crop is poor and people are selling at any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1890, my dear and loving son John. I guess that I must be close unto it, it's 30 years since you're gone. Because of all of the money you sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house. Bridget's daughters are grown. Thank you for sending your family picture. They are lovely young women and men. You say that you might even come for a visit. What joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1892, my dear brother John. I'm sorry that I didn't write sooner to tell you that Father passed on. He was living with Bridget. She says he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. I should have seen him playing with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was strong and the feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. It's funny the way he kept talking about you. He called for you again. Oh, why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd all love to see.